गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासरूम ऑफ चाणक्य अकेडमी इंग्लिश मीडियम स्टैंडर्ड 12th कॉमर्स. टुडे इज द रिविजन सेशन फॉर चैप्टर नंबर 4, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड कॉमर्स ऑफ सब्जेक्ट दैट इज ओसी. ओसी के चैप्टर 4 का हम आज रिविजन करेंगे. वी विल क्विकली रिवाइज in 15 minutes about the topics that we have learnt in this chapter. Okay, so the first and foremost thing is the introduction or the meaning of organization. In general terms, I can say that formal administrative structure that is formed to make the planning successful or for the implementation of planning, it is known as organizing. The structure formed in order to enable delegation of authority and responsibility towards the people who are actively engaged for the common goal is known as organization. Right? Organization is needed whenever there are more than one person who are working together. It is popularly said that management is the brain of business, planning is the soul of business, and organization is the body, because body works according to the instruction passed by brain, and brain takes the decision on the basis of soul, that is planning. Okay, next, the meaning you already know, right? Definition, we will see the various definitions given by Chester I. Barnard and Louis Allen. Chester I. Barnard says that the activity conducted by the cooperation of two or more people and their coordination is known as organizing, whereas Sri Louis Allen says that organizing is the process of identifying and classifying the work to be performed, defining and delegating the responsibility and authority, and also establishing the relationship for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together in accomplishing the goals. Okay, now the concept of organizing says that it is inevitable to have management without organizing. By now you have understood that management cannot be made effective without proper organizing. Organizing reduces the wastage of time, money and energy as it results into optimum utilization of everything. If one word is to be given for the word organizing, it is arrangement. Arrangement of how the organizing will be working, how the employees will be, how interrelated with each other, and also delegation of authority and responsibility. What are the characteristics of organizing? It is a goal-oriented activity. It is based on planning. It involves delegation of authority and responsibility. It is important to human element because human is at the center and all these managerial functions are done on human. Organizing is flexible and can be changed as per the requirement. It establishes the interrelationships among the employees. Monitoring and controlling over the task becomes easy with organizing. Organizing is a group activity and controlled administrative structure can be formed. How to do the organizing? That is, the step for the process of organizing includes clarification of objective, then defining the functions of the organization, and then departmentation of the function, that is categorizing the function according to different departments, and then to determine the departmental position and abilities, finding out the post and the employees who will be working in all the departments. Then we will delegate the power and responsibilities at various levels of management and employees, developing the interrelationship, and to prepare the organizational chart. How many types of structures of organization are there? There are 5 types of organizational structures: linear organization, functional organization, formal organization, informal, and matrix organization. Let us talk about linear organization. In this, the distribution of power and authority, power and responsibilities is done in straight line from top to bottom levels. And this is known as linear organization. How is it formed? In this structure, the whole organization is divided into various divisions or segments. Divisional officer is appointed for each particular segment, and they are responsible to hire officers for their function. Divisional officers is assigned all the powers for his particular segment, and this formation is there according to division and not the function. Okay, and that is why it is called linear organization. Next one is functional organization, a structure which is formed with special knowledge based expert are given responsibilities in the particular unit. It is known as functional organization. अब इसका फॉर्मेशन कैसे होता है? तो फंक्शनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन प्रेस फोकसेस ऑन वर्क डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड स्पेशलाइजेशन. वन इज स्पेशलाइज इन मार्केटिंग, वन इन सेल्स एंड अदर इन सर्विस. इन दिस स्ट्रक्चर डिवीजन ऑफ वर्क इज नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू यूनिट्स बट अकॉर्डिंग टू द नेचर ऑफ वर्क. ओके, फॉर ईच काइंड ऑफ वर्क डिफरेंट एक्सपर्ट्स आर अपॉइंटेड. Such experts are not only the advisors but administrative head responsible for the task assigned to them. For example, teen different plant hai to teenon ke marketing manager ek hi, teen unke selling ka department ek ke paas, servicing or maintenance ka department ek ke paas. So that the one who is in the marketing will look for the marketing of all the varieties of products of the organization. Third one is your formal organization. Now the formal structure of relationship among person and work is established, and that is known as formal organization. What are the two types? Linear and functional that we learned previously are example or type of formal organization only. Characteristics of formal organization include: it is a formal structure, preformed structure done in planning. It lacks flexibility because it emphasizes employees to go in the same organizational structure. Delegation of power is from upper level to lower level. It is applied or applicable in large size business firms, right? And the communication or mode of communication is written. Next is informal organization. Informal organization is that formation of internal relationship automatically formed on its own in order to provide the contribution to some result achievement, and they are formed without any planning. The relations are developed among the people who are working together. Hence, no formal or proper chart can be prepared for the same. It is also said to be the shadow of the formal structure of organization. What are the characteristics? It is an informal structure. It is completely based on human relation and human terms with each other, continuously changing from person to person and group to group. It is universal because it is found everywhere, wherever there exists any organization. Mode of communication is informal, that is generally verbal. Size of this type of organization is small as it is found inside the formal organizations. There is a lack of control, and it is also the complement to the formal structure. Next one is matrix organization, the modern kind of organization which has two different type of structure. Ek the simple structure where the decision making process is there, and on the other hand there is structure solving the technical problems, जिसको हम बोलते हैं project structure. So there are two different structures. Simple structure, that is decision making process, and technical structure, जिसको बोलते हैं project structure, and the combination of these two is known as matrix organization. Now what happens in matrix organization? In this we find the combination of function based and project based departmentalization. This is department based, sorry, this is function based, and this is department based, right? Project managers are appointed as per the number of projects, right? The responsibility of project manager is to complete the project assigned to them on time. This is the responsibility of project manager, and this is the responsibility of production manager. Thus the expert from different staff members are obtained for function of the project work and development. They are divided into two groups. For example, computer experts are there, development research expert are also there, and product design experts are also there. Next, what we are going to see is decentralization, the delegation of power from upper to lower level in orderly manner. It is known as decentralization. Henry Fayol has defined decentralization as to assign power to the superiors, to enable distribution of work, and to include them in decision making process is called decentralization. Now, why decentralization is important? So decentralization leads to quick decision. It reduces the workload of top level. It increases the motivation among the subordinates and middle and bottom level management. It increases the managerial abilities of the person who is given the responsibilities, or who is these responsibilities of decentralized organization. It makes control effective, and harmony is created among the individuals. Last topic of this chapter is delegation of authority. The delegation of authority means that delegation process in which the manager gives his authority to subordinates along with the duties, and the subordinate with the help of other for the purpose of work performance accepts the authority consciously. One another thing I would like to add is that whenever the organizations are large, upper level administration assign the work to help us to check if orders are followed or not. And in order to enable such task helper to perform their task well, powers are given to them, and that is known as delegation of authority. What is the importance of this delegation of authority? It makes management efficient. Development of employees take place. It motivates the employees and the helpers as well, who are given the different task and responsibility. It gives the benefit of specialization, because so that a specialized person can be given the task accordingly, and there is a scope for expansion, because top level delegates their work to the bottom or middle level management, and these top level can now focus on all other areas of expansion. What are the elements of this delegation of authority? It includes responsibility, authority, and accountability. Entrustment of responsibility means it is the assigning the work to an individual managers, assign certain responsibility for completion of task. Then conferment of authority means the power to take the decision, and along with the responsibility was authority. This is also given to the subordinates and helper so that they can get the work done from the lower levels. And last one is creation of accountability, means to check whether the subordinates are performing the responsibility in expected manner or not. Delegated authority holder has to provide the proper explanation and follow the reporting process to the top level management, and it is known as accountability. Okay, children, I hope by now you are clear with the concepts of this chapter, organizing. From tomorrow, we will start with the next chapter, that is staffing. For any doubts and queries, you can contact me anytime. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.